watch it. So Christina comes over, and you know, we make some popcorn, and it's one of those days. Half the popcorn falls on the floor. Nobody wants to watch a movie at the same time. In the old days, you know, like, you're sitting around the living room, and you're waiting for them to go on, so you're watching the movie at the same time. But today, try to get...
could the rioters be made to clean up their damage for a lot of public people?
components. We have the hopper, the barrel, the nozzle. The
brain yourself to think in conversations or to hear other voices or your own more often. We don't even know if you should want to make those changes, if there are benefits or downsides of different kinds of inner speech. And it's probably going to be a while before we have any clear answers, because our methods...
Es obligatorio y antes de entrar está vacío, nada más está ahí Miguel esperando comer
y listo.
Y hay que sacrificar dos papos.
Making an electromagnetic field that the tiny coils on the S-pin
getting creative in whiskey making. You're talking about finishing, the grain being used, the what's it?
And that's a good question. Why are we focusing on the number of infections when we know it's something that doesn't hurt most people with the infection? Clearly there's some doubts about lingering effects, which we should keep an eye on. But I think we don't know enough about that, but it's certainly dangerous. So I think that the likely outcome is that the somebody in the long term would be to, let's say, influence movies and television to produce positive or negative portrayals of whatever you would like society to see as a good way or a bad way. We know that that happens, we know that it works, we know that it's a gigantic. So far you all understand that that is very science and history driven. There's no hyperbole going on yet. It's a routine thing to influence the media, to influence the... For domestic stuff, you can still make your arguments. Here's something that only I would say.
Get all of the chicken brown.
From the time I race the whip up to the time it cracks is a lot more time to think. It's a lot more time to just feel what the whip is doing instead of just boom, boom, like you would with a forklift. Cattleman's crack feels great. Overhead crack feels very smooth, good length, good timing. we were to reverse that overhead crack and do another one, go straight into another one, plenty of time for me to orient my arm in a good way, allows the loop to crack. Let's do some fast figure eights, much more manageable. Volley, much better. Overhead flick. Much time you have to work with, and it's not excessive. It's not such a heavy whip that you are struggling to hold the thing above the ground like you'll see with some of these longer whips that we're about to test out. So, 6 foot whip, it's a great beginner's whip as far as length goes. A 7 foot whip, there isn't a huge difference, just a little bit more time. You get a little bit more time in between. This is one of the favorite whips I've ever made. I actually had to keep it. It is more of a streamlined target whip built on a 3/16 inch spring steel rod with 2 plaited bellies, 16 plaid overlay. It's quickly becoming my favorite whip that I've ever made. But look at the time here that we have to work with. Everything is just...
Another golden rule is never ride faster than you're able to foot brake. That's when you get yourself into trouble. Foot braking is going to wear down your shoes. To maximize your shoe life, alternate between using your toes and your heels. Should never do that. Earlier on, I mentioned a correct body position requires you to have your weight on your front foot. How are you going to get your weight on your front foot if you're taking it off your board? So, based off of that logic, don't push Mongo. It also kind of looks weird. Now we're going to talk about one of my